Brooklyn 214 podcast, we're back. It's your boy K Lou. Got my boy Brooklyn over here.
Yeah, yeah.
Got Kev Sony in the third over here. Oh, we talked about a couple stuff. There's a couple stuff we missed too, because we started rumbling off on our personal opinions. So we're gonna get right into that. Before we do that, we're gonna play our choosing game. It's been a couple of weeks since we played it. So we're gonna get back into it today, and we're gonna add some of the stuff that y'all was talking about last time, because it didn't make no sense to me. Talking about Janet and Mary saying, like, it don't make no sense to me. I'm not buying none of that crap. But before we do that, we were talking about NBA. I forgot to mention the play that Rondo did against the Spurs with 15 seconds left. They was down by three. People on Facebook are taking, well, maybe like two people are taking Rondo's side. And then there's even people blaming LeBron for that play. I want your opinion on that. Because Rondo, to me, wide open, it's 12 seconds at that time that you got the ball under the basket. Go up for two, make the layup, take the go for the steal. If you don't get it, foul. Worst case scenario, they make both foul shots, you down by three again, but you have another possession. Instead of wasting 15 seconds and LeBron shooting up a stupid shot, a fourth shot, because you wasted all this time. So, what's your opinion on that?
First off,
and here go the play right here. So y'all see Rondo wide open.
Wide open, he could have shot it.
He could have shot it, and it would have been 12 seconds left.
Right, now, whoever's talking all this crap about he was right for doing that.
Yeah.
They don't know basketball. Period.
Quentin Moore, I'm talking about you.
Quentin Moore, whoever you are. Quentin respect Moore. Your opinion, even though it's ridiculous.
That's my homie. I'll be playing music.
Good music.
I don't give a damn who it is. It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
You go, you get the points. You're already down. Get the points. 12 seconds left.
Brandon Beecham.
You foul him immediately.
Brandon Beecham say it was a smart move by. He's a.
How that a smart move?
He's a Rondo fan. You can't tell him nothing. That's why I don't bring him on the show.
Brandon Beecham is a Rondo fan.
He's a Celtics fan. So he loves Rondo because Rondo won a ring.
What's up, Brandon?
Yeah, man. Bean, get out of here, bro. You don't know what you're talking about, bro. That was stupid. Rondo had the ball. You go up. Simple. Go up.
Mm-hmm. Get the points, foul immediately.
Exactly. If you don't get the steal, foul. Easy. You get another possession to plan for it.
You're still taking the same chance that you are, you know, after the play that they tried to do. But it benefits you more with 12 more seconds on the clock.
Exactly. So, man, that's stupid to me. Now, one more thing we've got to talk about. You know, we talked about Jimmy Butler trying to get away from Minnesota, calling himself what's his name? Wiggins. Call it Wiggins soft. Calling Carl Anthony Towns soft. Did y'all see Carl Anthony Towns quit in Toronto?
He's soft.
Basically, you know, he was having a bad game. Feel like he didn't want to play. Just had this bad demeanor, bad body language.
It's the first of many bad games.
But you a pro.
Everybody going to have a bad game.
You are a pro.
You the star of the team.
You know,
you the big man.
Come on, man.
He shoot an air ball three, and you hear the announcers like, yo, Cat has to get out. He don't want to play. And as soon as he said it, you see Carl Anthony Towns point to the bench.
He took himself out.
Took himself out the game and sat on the end of the bench and pouted. Like, you don't do that, man. You do not do that.
Got to play through.
So, I feel what Jimmy Butler's, I feel where he's coming from. He said it after last year. They got exposed last year in the playoffs. That's the reason why Jimmy Butler feels how he feels now. Because Carl Anthony Towns got basically shut down by a team really with no big man presence that should be shutting them down.
They don't want to win. They're about their money and personal stats.
Yeah, that mentality he showed last night is not one that's going to get you through.
Yeah, it's horrible, man. But we had to go over there because we forgot to do that. Now, the choosing game. It's going to get a little interesting. I'm going to start off with a comedian. The greatest comedian, Eddie Murphy or Richard Pryor?
Richard Pryor,
man. Eddie Murphy got his style from Richard Pryor.
Richard Pryor has more stand-ups.
But hey, on the flip side, he is funny. Now, in Eddie Murphy's defense, Richard Pryor had a lot of his jokes written by
Paul Mooney.
Paul Mooney.
Now, what you should say is who had the funnier movies. That's the competition.
Paul Mooney don't do movies like that.
No, I'm just saying, who had the funnier
movies? I mean, excuse me.
Eddie Murphy did Richard Pryor.
Richard Pryor.
He had a ton of movies. Which way is
different times, man. You talking about the 80s.
I'm sorry, man. I know Richard Pryor is the guy that basically got everything started for us in comedy. But I've watched his stuff multiple times. And he is funny. And I watch Eddie's stuff. And then, to me, like you said, I added Eddie movies. Eddie is the GOAT to me.
See, but Eddie has two stand-up specials that we, you know what I mean, that we really just know about. It's Delirious and Raw.
Which one of those are better?
I think Raw. Raw had me dying. He was funny in it.
Oh, man, because a different point from my life. Delirious. When I was younger, Delirious was more funny than me. When I am older and I understand what he was talking about more in Raw, I think Raw is funny because of the adult content. But Delirious, that had me as a kid understanding everything and laughing, too.
Delirious
so,
was funny.
Delirious was funny. Delirious was funny. But Here and Now by Richard Pryor is the most classic comedy album, you know, period.
I would watch both Eddie Murphy's Raw and Delirious before that one.
What?
Before what?
Before Here and Now. Richard Pryor. Not Live at Sunset Strip, which is another funny one.
I would too.
Yes, I would do Here and Now first, because Here and Now is Here and Now is actually the structure that comedians started following after that concert. They started following that structure of how do they come.
When Eddie Murphy was in his prime, that's when I was old enough. I was still a kid, but old enough to understand what he was talking about.
Yeah.
Richard Pryor came a little before me, so I wasn't really listening to his stuff back then like that.
Yeah. I listened to Richard Pryor sneaking because my dad had the albums around when they went to work.
You know, now you know what's a good Richard Pryor movie? See No Evil, Hear No Evil. Where he's deaf.
Deaf, and Gene Wilder is blind. Yes.
Hilarious.
No, he's blind. Gene Wilder is deaf.
Yeah, right. It's hilarious, man.
That's a funny one. That's funny. I would say Richard Pryor movie, I think it would be Which Way Is Up.
Yeah, that one's funny too.
Which Way Is Up, where he played like four or five different characters, and you know, that right there is crazy thing to do.
Brewster's Millions, where he had to spend that money.
Brewster's Millions was good.
I seen that.
That was funny too.
Brewster's Millions was very good.
That was funny too.
Critical Condition. See,
that's Richard a hard Pryor one between Eddie Murphy and. I'm going to still go Eddie Murphy because that was more my era.
Yes, I see it, and I can totally understand that.
But
Eddie Murphy.
And see, and I have to lean towards it because that is more my era.
You came way after Richard Pryor.
But I still go back and watch his
The
stuff.
Movies.
Like,
I would go watch. I would watch Eddie Murphy movies over Richard Pryor movies.
Watch a stand-up.
Stand-up, I gotta go Richard Pryor. Just more content, more opportunities to have fun.
Eddie Murphy is the GOAT to me.
Bicentennial Nigga is one of the funniest albums in the world.
Yeah, I don't know. Eddie Murphy is the GOAT to me. That's just, that's what I'm sticking with. Speaking of GOATs, we kind of did this one already. Me and you, Brooklyn. But let's kind of go into it again because I had some people arguing with me on Instagram about it. Who is the greatest Laker of all time?
Magic Johnson. I just saw a current, you know what, and I may be a little biased, I just saw a highlight reel from him the other day on YouTube. I don't know how I ended up watching it, and I was just like, dang, I forgot how, you know what I mean, how amazing he was.
Listen, the reason this came up was at work. I asked these dudes, two Lakers fans, who was a GOAT, period, and they said Magic over MJ. So I thought about it. I didn't normally instantly shut people down when they say MJ's not the GOAT. But you got to think about it. Magic did change the game up.
Mm-hmm.
He did. So we can't just use that for MJ.
He made that position.
Yeah,
amazing.
Magic played all five positions.
Mm-hmm.
Started at center and won what, the Finals MVP as a rookie.
Took
you got to think
took
if,
over for
if Magic didn't get sick.
Took over for Kareem.
If Magic didn't catch the dragon, as people call it, what would have happened?
Because he had a couple more years of him for real.
So he did come back, but still.
The question, but the question of MJ over, is it the question of Magic over MJ or just who's the GOAT?
Well, I guess when you narrow down
Magic
just those two.
Over MJ.
Yeah, well, I was going to say, that's not an argument.
That's not
right
even
there.
A question.
Yeah, that's not an argument.
There was no comparison with those two.
But
that takes nothing away from Magic Johnson.
Yeah, but do you put MJ as a GOAT?
Hell yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is that an argument?
Hands down.
Does anybody have an argument?
Hands down.
Yes. That's what they were saying at work.
So that Magic said, you know what?
Magic is the GOAT over MJ.
I think it's a time thing.
Just for the fact that he played.
They on drugs.
I don't think it's anybody that you can convince from our age range that MJ is not the best. But 10 years younger than us, and they might throw LeBron in there and have a real argument. Just because. You know what I mean?
LeBron is old. He has to win at least one more ring.
If you talk to an older guy, maybe 20 years old enough, they'll probably throw Bill Russell in there. For real. Or stick with MJ. I mean, stick with Magic Johnson. Because Magic Johnson was a big deal to them cats, man, back in the day. You know what I mean? He was a big deal.
So where does Kobe fit into all of this?
I don't think he... And I would like for the Black Mamba to be there because I am a fucking Kobe fan. Yeah. Sorry about the cussing on Sunday. I'm a Kobe fan. Like I really think, and to be honest with you, I think you put the Black Mamba in his prime against most of them, and I'm sorry, fuss me down. I believe he can take MJ.
That's an argument
I've been having for years.
When we talked about our Laker conversation back then, it came from my status and caused a big uproar on Facebook saying, if Jordan's the GOAT, Kobe Bryant basically did everything Jordan did, style-wise and everything, and he's only one ring short. How is Kobe not in the conversation?
Gotta put Kobe in the conversation, man. And Kobe went through.
But people,
he went through adversity just like
MJ. I'm not saying greatest all time for Kobe. I'm saying greatest Laker all time.
Who's the greatest?
Kobe for me is up there.
He's up there.
Kobe is up there for me.
I say Kobe. He brought five rings.
Do we even care about Jerry West? Because I don't know nothing about Jerry West.
I mean, I've seen a few of his games from but. Again, that's ahead of my time. So before my time. So
I can't to go there. Yeah,
my time with the Lakers was Kareem and Magic and all of them. You know what I'm saying?
But that was the early phase, remember?
Right. That's when they all were young.
But real time with the Lakers was Kobe and Shaq. When they was like,
stage. Yeah. That's when I was like, damn.
Yeah. So I said it to that, and that's where I'm at with.
Pick by Eli, by the way.
God. Doggy, what is wrong with this guy?
I think the Redskins look like it's gonna happen.
Another pick by Eli, by the way.
They really wanted to.
They're tanking, man.
But
this Eli last game is
done. No, okay. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Nobody even said anything about him, and they did. Dang it, the man invented a shot.
On Instagram, they did. See, the thing is, when I said Kobe, just brought his name up to see what people say. Dude's like, yeah, it's automatically Kobe. I said, well, people gonna use the argument that Kobe had Shaq for three of them championships.
Mm-hmm.
And he was like, well, Shaq wasn't doing this.
He won two more with him.
Shaq won the finals MVP every single year.
Mm-hmm. When Shaq was in his prime in the league.
Exactly. So,
God dang.
I'm not saying Shaq is the GOAT because he's not.
No, I'm not saying he's GOAT, but I'm just saying,
that's the argument against Kobe.
Yeah, but you gotta
be like that. They say Magic had Kareem and Kareem had Magic.
But when Kareem was on his downside of his career, Magic took over that team and kept them, you know what I mean, as a mad opponent for anybody. I mean, you had to get through the Lakers just like you had to get through the Pistons.
So who's the GOAT? Laker.
I'm going to say Magic Johnson.
Kobe. I'm going to say Kobe. Magic, a very close second.
That's tough, man.
I put Kobe as a close second.
That's tough.
I put Kareem as my third.
Kobe got two numbers retired, so I'm going to say Kobe for that reason alone.
Did Wilt Chandler play for them? Wilt Chandler's number four based on the women he banged.
I don't know, man, because Magic... I'm gonna go with Kobe, I guess. Kobe brought five championships.
I think that's a valid, you know.
I'm gonna go with Kobe.
Although Twitter and Facebook is gonna try to, you know.
That's definitely gonna be an argument. I already know it is, so ready for it now. Now, let's choose between these. Shaun Alexander or Jamal Lewis in their prime? Running back.
Alexander played for Seahawks.
Yeah, Jamal.
Yeah.
Jamal in Baltimore.
Nah.
Or Cleveland or whatever.
Alexander.
You sure? Because Jamal Lewis had that record.
Yeah, no doubt. Yeah, I hear you, but I just like his style better. He just...
I can see that, but I got
it. He was the truth back then, man. I like him, man. I like Jamal Lewis too, but...
You like Shawn Alexander better than him?
Yeah. I mean, for my style, yeah. He was the truth, man. He was big as hell. You know who he reminded me of a little bit? Brandon Jacobs. Like, just hard to bring down. It's hard to bring. Brandon Jacobs sucked as a running back. He was just hard to bring down. He was big as hell.
I feel that way about Emerson.
Okay. So, since you're picking him over him, Shawn Alexander or Jerome Bettis?
Which is, I don't like your Steelers.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Come on,
man.
I'm
trying to see where you're at with the Shawn Alexander.
I'm trying to be biased, y'all, but y'all know I'm finna go to Jerome Bettis. You know it.
The bus?
Chubby.
I'm just trying to see where you are.
This man was so fat, he out there.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Non-stop, baby.
By the way, that was a very disrespectful question.
I'm trying to make sure. I want to see where you are with this. Because you started talking about Sean Alexander. Like,
I like that dude, man. He was hype.
Okay. So, in their prime, Emmitt Smith or Herschel Walker?
Herschel Walker. Herschel Walker. Athleticism alone.
Boy, knocking out 1,000 putting.
Man, and he don't understand why yet, because he ain't been diagnosed. He just out there just ravaging people, man.
Let's be clear. Emmitt Smith got that rushing record because my boy said to set his butt down.
And that's
because
Herschel was gone.
That's
because Emmitt Smith never wanted to retire until he got that rushing.
What did he play? 18 seasons?
I don't care if I had to go 20 yards a season.
How many seasons Emmitt Smith played? It was up there. Like,
and remember, he was getting like a little bit.
Emmitt was cold.
He was, but look at that line, too.
After a while, you know,
Barry Sanders did that without a line. Loose. Without a line, look what Barry Sanders was doing.
Goddamn!
Imagine he was on that Cowboy scene. Ooh.
I wanted him to win. I wanted him to win. So bad. He was such a good player. Cool. Lions just, you know what I mean? He just got frustrated with it. Maybe he did. Maybe he was like, oh, yeah, I'm satisfied.
So, who's the next great one to be in the NBA? Ben Simmons or Jason Tatum?
Tatum. All day. Ben Simmons, he can't shoot. At all, man.
I believe that you're going to hear a story about Ben Simmons later on in 30 for 30 saying when he added that shot, his game went to another level.
This basically,
I'm going Ben Simmons.
This basically is...
He's going to add that shot.
He shoots like he's having a damn seizure. Sometimes
it happens after season number 9. You know what I mean? You know, you never know.
That's too young.
Yeah, if he don't got it by the third season or so, maybe fourth.
Am I saying that? Grant Hill. Because of injuries took forever, so I think that
Grant Hill came in from Duke.
I know he came in, but then you know he
hurt his ankle,
and he went away, and he came back and showed you can make it
happen. He still did.
Ben Simmons gonna add that shot, and he's gonna improve.
So this is basically like a newer generation version of Kobe versus LeBron that we're about to see here.
Oh, Kobe versus Tracy McGrady, because
they compare Ben Simmons to LeBron. Ben Simmons is basically what LeBron. Came in, you could get to the rim at ease, you could pass with ease, but you can't shoot.
You can't shoot. But LeBron had a better shot than he did back then, too, when he came in.
And Kobe, Tatum and Kobe played just alike. Tatum worked with Kobe all in the offseason, and you can see it. The post-up game is all Kobe moves.
The difference with Tatum now and Kobe back then, in his first, second, third season, Tatum seems a lot more, like, fluid and under control with it.
Yeah.
Kobe was kind of erratic at times. You don't see that from Tatum. Tatum is, man,
Kobe
was his fifth, sixth season. He's going to be killing.
But Tatum has had Kobe
killing
watch
now.
Too.
Barring injuries, watch.
Yeah, Tatum a monster, man. I'm going with Tatum. I'm going with Tatum on that one. Now, we talked about this a little bit. Was it off camera? He might have been on camera or last one. But the current Golden State Warriors versus the LeBron's Miami Heat. That was off camera, okay. The current Warriors or LeBron's Miami Heat. With prime D-Wade, healthy D-Wade, healthy Chris Bosh.
Golden State.
Golden State.
Too
many shooters. Would have beat them.
Too many shooters.
Gotta go with Golden State because of what the Mavericks did to that team.
And what I like, they play defense. It's not just we just launching shots. They play defense. I like them.
I want to go for that Heat team so bad, but the Mavericks dismantled them. Imagine what Golden State could do. You know what I mean? And what nothing wrong with that team that the Mavericks beat. Nothing wrong with them.
Yeah, that was their first year. I'm talking about more of when they added Ray Allen.
Same story.
These dudes scoring.
Oh, wait. When they added Ray Allen.
When they had Mike Miller shooting
threes. That still got to go.
Miller was old at that
this
point.
This Golden State has
Chalmers and all that.
This Golden State has
Chalmers inconsistencies. I don't know what, man.
You wasn't like that back then.
There you go.
What's the play?
Oh, ball. Let's go.
What's the play?
Run.
What's the play that they're about
come
to
on,
get?
Come on, y'all. Come on, y'all.
Catch him.
Oh,
Michael
my God. You run that slow. You see this?
Come on, man.
You running that slow?
Sorry, y'all. We got distracted. We're watching the Giants game.
Yeah, my mom's run faster than that.
Big turnover. Yeah, so I probably said Warriors too.
Warriors
had to win that one. They just dangerous dudes. Like, it's
now Cousins, I'm not saying that they're
watching Cousins play back.
It seems like we're putting the Warriors in the category of best team ever almost at some points here.
They have to be up there now.
They're up there, but are they that's a whole nother argument. Ready for research first. That's a whole nother argument.
They have to be up there now.
Cause I'm still saying they.
So okay, let's get to your girls. These weren't even part of the plan, but we're gonna get to them. Mary J. Blige singing Faith Evans.
I was your lover and your secretary.
Mary J. Blige singing Faith Evans. Okay.
You didn't say that at first. Now I got to say Faith Evans over Mary J. Blige as far as singing goes.
100%. Yeah, did you? 100% Faith. Faith can sing.
Exactly.
And she wrote a lot of songs.
Nah, y'all country boys say sing.
But Mary
she
J.
can sing, man.
You worry about your jazz.
Y'all country, man.
She can sing, alright?
So, sing. Okay. Let's think about some more.
But Mary J. Blige can sing. A lot of people say she cannot.
She can hold a note.
She can't mess with Faith, but she can sing.
She cannot blow. Mm-hmm. She can hold a note.
She can blow.
Yeah, I like Mary
she can blow. The reason I say she can blow is because I've heard her sing live before when she wasn't like on day number 58 of a 70-day tour.
She gives you a lot of drama with her singing that makes you think that she's doing more than what she's doing.
But I've seen her sing clean before. I've heard her sing Anita Baker's Sweet Love before, and that was amazing. I didn't know that was Mary J. Blige.
I compare Mary J. to Keisha Cole.
Whew. I cannot disagree with you on that one.
Thank you.
Well, Keisha Cole can sing.
Y'all compare Keisha Cole to Mary J. Blige.
Not saying that.
As far as singing, yes.
No, not like they. But they sing better than Keisha Cole.
Keisha Cole. Like her. But anyway. Nah, man. I go with Mary on that one.
Yeah. But we got Faith Evans over both of them. So Faith Evans right now is in the lead. Don't even bring up Ashanti. That would be unfair.
Yo, you see before she got famous.
Janet Jackson singing. Thanks about it. Ashanti.
Nah, Janet, man.
I was going to say Kelly Rowland.
No, that's not close. Kelly would kill Janet singing.
What? I would love to say that. But I'm sorry, man. When Kelly comes
you better,
out.
No, you better off comparing Janet
that
to
hit she had. And that wasn't yeah, whisper exactly. singing. That was whisper singing with Kelly Rowland went down.
What hit? Motivation?
Yes.
No, it wasn't.
Get out of here. Except on the chorus. Otherwise, she's, you know.
That is not an easy song to sing.
I didn't say it was an easy song to sing.
It's not a whisper song.
That's her voice.
She's pushing out. On that verse.
Sounded a little like it was held back and moderated to me. And when you're doing it, that means you don't want to stretch out too much because you don't know if you can do that in concert.
It's getting hot in here with this foolishness coming out. Yes, it is.
I know singers. You want to sing, you want to record something that you can sing in concert while you're hoarse. Janet Jackson sings like that. Kelly Rowland sings like that. They sing like that so they can do that in concert. They're barely pushing their voices. Now, I'm not saying they can't sing. But
it's not even close.
She started off in vocals on that song. What's the name of that damn song?
Motivation, right?
She started off in vocals on Motivation.
Are you serious? She didn't?
No, she did not show off no real vocals. Now, I've seen her sing backup stronger than what she did on Motivation. Motivation is a good song, but she's not showing off the extent of her voice.
You crazy, bro.
That slow song she came out with after that, well, it's a Motivation slow song, but it was another song talking about the hardship of the life. She sung her butt off on that one. Oh, but Motivation is a moderated, nice song. She can do that in a
sleep. That is not a... Dude, I seen females struggle singing that they can blow.
Because they can't sing. Just because you can sing loud don't mean you can sing. If you can sing soft, you can sing. Case in point. Janet Jackson sings soft. Janet Jackson sings soft. Play the song. I mean, I'm not afraid.
Okay.
You know what
I mean? Janet Jackson or 7th Streeter.
I haven't seen enough out of Streeter. I'm sticking with Janet.
Singing?
No, but as far as singing on the song, yeah, we're talking about the song, right?
Bruh,
just singing ability? Of course, now you can't put Janet up there with the major singers. No, I didn't say she was. All right? You can't
Sam put her up there. She's not a major singer.
But she can sing better than Janet Jackson. Let's just establish that, okay?
Yeah, okay,
she can do better.
How you saying Janet is a singer?
She's a singer. She can do better than a lot of singers out there. Okay.
Yeah.
So they gonna be hearing different music.
Yeah, yeah, they gonna hear different music, but this is
that's whispering.
Not that. No, that's her voice. She's not stretching. She talks like that. That's her vocal range when she's talking. She just pushing.
She's not singing.
She's not. No, I didn't say she wasn't singing. I'm saying she's not stretching herself. You talking about she was stretching and singing hard? She barely singing. This is her regular voice. She talks like this. People, you just. This is a song she can do in her sleep. There's no stretching here. No,
are you serious?
Do you hear the way she just said "make mama proud"? That was. There's no cadence or nothing in that right there, people. I'm not. Kelly Rowland is my favorite male death of his child. Okay, don't get me wrong.
Oh, look right through his
but
head.
The song "Motivation," she's not stretching herself at all. The other song she did, that slow one where she was talking about the stuff she went through, she stretched herself. She showed her vocal range.
Dirty Laundry.
Yes, on this song right here, that's no vocal. She's just singing. And that's okay, but she's not showing no vocal range in the song right there. That's no vocal range.
I can't believe right now, bro.
Make mama proud. Come on, man. That sounded pretty lame. You know what I mean? And she, the way she all sung right. it, too,
Savage
she had no
crazy.
Confidence behind it.
Even Savage said he's crazy.
I'm a singer. I'm just... Singers will agree with me.
Bro.
Singers will agree with me. All right?
No, they won't.
Singers will agree with me.
No, they won't. I'm going to post this. They not going to agree with you on this.
Post
bro.
It. Post
they,
this right here.
They not
she won't. Is not stretching her voice on this song right here. There are other songs where she is showing off her voice. She showed off her voice more on the background of Crazy in Love than she did on this song right here. So, come on, man. I'm not saying she can't sing. I'm just saying this song, she did not stretch herself out, and that's okay. Just like okay, Janet Jackson with Anytime, Anyplace. She didn't stretch herself out.
So, period. Janet better sing than Kelly?
No.
I'm just trying to figure somebody where you go actually say Janet sings better than.
Nah.
Since you said Janet is a singer.
She's
Janet
a singer.
Janet better than Ciara?
She's a singer. Yes.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
Janet over Ciara?
Janet Jackson can sing better.
You buggy.
Cause the song All Right and the song Escapade shows me that she can sing better than Ciara.
No.
Tell Escapade she keeps saying the high tones. That don't matter.
No, bro.
She sings better. Then, hold up, for real? You can't even name 5 Ciara songs.
I actually can.
You with the list right there, yeah. I mean, you can just go right down the list, yeah.
But now I'm trying to find a song where she's actually singing.
You ain't gonna find it.
It's a couple of them.
You're not gonna find it.
Dude, what's
this?
It is hot. The sun started peeking up in her.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty hot.
Body parting. You singing in there again?
No, I don't remember.
Not. She's not. She's doing with the Janet Jackson thing, the whisper singing.
But that's all Janet did. That's all Janet did, bro.
What's the song where Janet Jackson sounded like she was crying on
All of them? She used her voice on screen with Michael Jackson.
There you go.
Okay, but she sounded like Mike.
Escapade. All Right. Black Cat.
Making a bunch of noises, dude.
What does Janet do?
Ciara cannot sing, man.
Janet is
no. I'm sorry. Let me take that back. Ciara can sing. Ciara is not a powerhouse singer.
Janet's not.
Janet's not a powerhouse singer, but she sings better than Ciara, though.
They sound the same.
Synthesized. Janet Jackson was doing this without the computer.
This particular song, there, I see the similarity, but yeah. I think Janet sings better than her.
Because she sings that way without the computer. You can hear that, you know. That's weak, Ciara. That is the weakest Ciara song that she's come out with in a while. Pittsburgh Steelers over the Browns, of course. Of course.
That's what I'm gonna sing.
God dang.
Yeah, it got hot, dude.
I'm losing weight.
Come on, man.
Well, no. Enough.
Yeah, that's trash. All right, so we have established that Janet Jackson is a singer, but not one of the best.
Let me ask you this. What you think about Ella May?
You know what? I haven't heard much, but what I've heard, that's nice. That's nice. That's real nice. That's real nice right there.
Ella May is pretty dope.
That's real nice right there. There's another singer.
Go turn the fan on, please.
Yeah, dang, man.
I don't care if it's on camera or not. Turn the fan.
Something better right here.
That sun blasted, but we done with this. That's all I had for the choosing anyway, but.
That was a good one.
I can't believe y'all talking about Janet as a singer.
I'm the Faith Evans fan out there that's saying
she's
that we should stop
talking about
Faith.
She can sing too. She's alright.
She can sing too, man.
She's alright.
She can sing too.
I'm gonna look up some Janet songs again.
Look up All Right With Me. She sings her butt off in this.
Janet had great music and she could dance her butt off. And then she'll give you a strip tease on stage.
She has a song called come to this body that loves you? Yes. Even though that song is just like all the rest of it. But it's still a nice song.
Who's the best white boy singer? John B. or Robin Thicke?
Justin.
Robin Thicke.
I mean, he's back. Robin Thicke is killing John B. But my personal preference is Justin Timberlake.
Singing, entertaining, everything.
All around. He got the full package.
Singing is Justin be sneaking his runs in on them songs.
What's that song?
He ain't trying to flood the industry every 6 months. You bringing out something new.
That Mirror song was.
You trying to miss him?
That was good.
But it is what it is, man. Bam, 214 podcast. We're done for the day. So. If y'all missed us, we back.
Sweating to the audience.
Yeah, it got super hot all of a sudden.
The song is right there now. It's right there.
Yeah.
But it is what it is. K Lou, Kid Sony the Third, my boy Brooklyn.
NYC.
We watching these Giants lose as always.
And watching the Steelers win.
Yeah, so it is what it is.
Really? You want to end it off like that?
Yes, sir. Brooklyn 214 podcast. Giants suck.
We out. Hater, bro. Peace.